I've just completed the basic welcome menu tutorial. So go watch that one and you'll see how I wrote this code. I want to add a little more to my menu now. So I'm going to go back into this gallery. And this time I want to pick someone to put on the screen. So I'm going to pick the night mail picture. I'm going to scale it up a little bit. Something like 2.5 would be great. There we go. And I'm going to put him, kind of want him in the middle on the left. There's no middle left location, so I'm going to have to do little vectors here. So we'll do west, which is the left edge of the screen. Times 0.7, so that I put him 7/10 of the way from the middle to the left edge at the center vertically. So let's look at that. There we go. So we've got a picture anyway. So let's create a new character here. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to say, let's see, character 1 or 2. I'm going to say when this boolean is true, then it displays the knight. When it's false, it displays a different character. So let's just do that. So when true, display the knight. Else, display, and go back to the gallery. I went to character gallery. Display my default player here. Alright. And then when I'm on the menu, when we do the right bumper, you know what? I'm going to do something different. Let's do any bumper. When any bumper is pressed, we're going to use toggle. I'm not sure where toggle is. I think it's under math. Yep, there it is. We're going to toggle this. Toggle means if it was false, make it true. If it was true, make it false. So we'll toggle back and forth between these characters. So no matter which bumper I press, goes back and forth. So I'm gonna make this guy a template. And then I'm going to create a new character. Grab that knight mail. Him a template as well. True. Alright. So now at the bottom here, when the menu is not being shown anymore, we're going to create. Well, I need to see which one I'm doing, so if it's character 1 or 2, if it's character 1, that is the knight. So there are a couple ways to do this. I'm just going to do it the easy way. And we'll do else. We've selected the player. And we're going to pick our other template. And this at position means create them at the logic cube that I'm using now. Alright, and I think that's it. So that allows us to choose... Always use once when you create something. That's funny. If you don't do once, you get infinite creates. So we'll do else. Okay, we want to create one person. So I did infinite knights before. So we have our player. He moves them around. If I restart the level, this time I'm going to choose a knight. And we start as a knight. His brain is not really... He's got some sort of weird default brain. So I will set his brain to... This third person adventure is the brain that your default player gets. So... Choose the knight, and now I'm playing as the knight. So that's a little bit more advanced way to do a menu. You can have all sorts of selectors and things. You could display an icon, and when you press the D-pad up or down, it selects between like new game and continue game, and you really can do whatever you want with your menu like that. So that's advanced menus in Project Spark.